Do you understand how dark it is? How far down the line we are? How late it is?
And I notice it's all over the news when he talks about, you know, he could waterboard Cheney and make him say he killed Sharon Tate and how ridiculous waterboarding is. Here's part of that clip. We'll go out of break, come back with the rest of it, and then go live to Jesse Ventura. Stay with us.
You had to watch it, Alex. You're good on you. Our country today is not the country that I defended when I was in the service back in the 1970s and 60s, because back in those days, you had to watch it, Alex. You're good on you. Back in those days, you still had to be charged with the crime before you were guilty of it. And today it seems that, and you back in those days, you had to be charged with the crime to be held. It seems today now they can arrest you, they can hold you for an undetermined, as long as they feel like it, like they're doing in Guantanamo.
Well, the Military Commissions Act says they can grab American citizens.
Which is absurd.
Well, I mean, how is it that the people running things aren't the bad guys? I'm not saying America's the bad guys, people that have seized the government. When they wrote memos saying it's okay to torture people's children in front of their parents, it's okay to kill them if you didn't mean to kill them under the torture or the enhanced interrogation techniques. And so they played the lawyer game of saying, well, we don't call electroshocks or pulling out fingernails. We don't call it torture. We call it enhanced interrogation, and then play that lawyer mind game. Can you speak
to
that?
I think I don't know about all of that, but I will speak directly about waterboarding.
Yeah, I mean, specifically about torture.
Well, no, I am. But I will
saying it's not torture.
I will only speak about waterboarding. I was waterboarding.
In training, I
was waterboarded by my own country. Now, if we call waterboarding torture, then why do we torture our own soldiers? And I'm not saying waterboarding isn't torture. It is. I deem it as torture. But yet I was waterboarded. Everybody that I knew was waterboarded because it was part of what they called SEER school, which was survival, escape, resistance, and evasion. It was a required course if you were going into the combat zone back in the era of Vietnam. I'm sure it's probably still required today.
Yeah, they were getting them ready to be tortured and to resist, and it's listed in those Army manuals as torture, so that disproves the White House later saying it isn't torture.
Well, and my simple response to all this, Alex, is I would like to take our five-time deferred Vice President, Dick Cheney, I would like to waterboard him. And let him then make the determination, having been waterboarded, then we'll ask him whether he thinks it's torture or not. I got a feeling he'd drop dead with the heart that he has today. If you waterboarded Dick Cheney, I feel that he would become a fatality because his weak heart wouldn't be able to take it. But my point being on doing that is I think these people that determine what torture is or isn't, I think they should first have it done to them.
Good
physically.
Point.
And then let them make an actual determination on whether they felt it was torture or not.
Can you describe what waterboarding was like?
It's drowning. It gives a complete sensation that you are drowning.
What did they do?
They strap you down, they put a towel across your face, and they start pouring water into the towel. And naturally, your mouth and that can't consume all the water. You can't drink it quick enough as they pour it. And it gives you the sensation it's going up your nose, it's going down your throat, and it gives you the complete feeling that you are drowning, even though you're not. The moment they stop it, you know, then it'll subside.
But that's the field waterboarding. They have another one where they put your head completely into a bathtub.
I don't know about that one.
Yeah.
The only kind we
they
got
kill people doing that.
The only kind we got was the field waterboarding back.
All right, we'll be right back with the rest of this. Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let's finish up that last 2 minutes or so, that little clip of Jesse Ventura when he first talked about waterboarding Cheney. That was the first time he ever talked about it that I knew of, and now it's big news today. We should have put that clip on the web. But let's go ahead and go back to that video. Here it is.
Can you describe what waterboarding was like?
It's drowning. It gives a complete sensation that you are drowning.
What did they do?
They strap you down, they put a towel across your face, and they start pouring water into the towel. And naturally, your mouth and that can't consume all the water. You can't drink it quick enough as they pour it. and it gives you the sensation it's going up your nose, it's going down your throat, and it gives you the complete feeling that you are drowning, even though you're not. The moment they stop it, you know, then it'll subside.
But that's the field waterboarding. They have another one where they put your head completely into a bathtub.
I don't know about that one.
Yeah.
The only kind we
got. They kill people doing that.
The only kind we got was the field waterboarding back in the days, the early 70s.
Oh, that's the classic one, man.
And they did it to all of us at Sears School. It was part of the training. And so my argument there is, if waterboard is indeed torture, which I think it is, how come we allow to torture? And for us SEALs, UDT SEAL guys, giving us waterboard, it was irrelevant. No, and I'll say that, it was irrelevant. Because in our platoons and in all the people that I served with, we all had an agreement. We would never be captured, we'll die first. So why would I need to face the waterboard if I'm dead? All of us were under an agreement that we will die first. We will not be captured. We will go down in a blaze of glory. So why did I need to be waterboarded? When I had already made a conscious decision that if it ever got to the position where I felt I was going to be captured, I would take death first. And I would say my attitude was, I'll take three or four of them with me before I go. Because always remember, the SEALs, we don't get mad, we get even. That's how we operate. I mean, you know, but so to me, I felt that the waterboarding and the whole POW thing was irrelevant to us, because there's never been a SEAL captured, nor do I believe there ever will be one.
Wow.
Because the SEAL will die first in our type of operation. You know, the only way they'd capture the SEAL is if the SEAL didn't know he was going to get captured.
Yeah.